Hi everyone, so I'm not sure who's going to be joining me live today because this was an impromptu thing to do because I was supposed to be going live with my friend Helen Weiss, who's actually based in Berlin. Helen does mindset stuff. She's a mindset coach, but she also does a lot more. She has Shine On Live TV. She interviews people around the world. She explores. She's basically a traveling nomad. She doesn't live in one place. And the plan was that she was going to be interviewing me about relationships because I'm a relationship counsellor. But we had some technology problems, we couldn't connect, and we spent ages trying to do the connection thing. And then we just decided, you know, we'll just reschedule. So I thought that a few weeks back I did mention that I'm going to try and do more live videos. And one of the things I've set for myself as a challenge is to do 7 days of live video. Now, some of that will be on my, hi, whoever's online, just say your name. I was just explaining that I'm just doing this live, 7 days of live video. Some of them might be on my personal page and some are going to be on my business page. But what I'm going to be talking about this week is about relationship dilemmas. So the first thing that I do want to say is that I don't talk about my clients directly because that's like breaking confidentiality. Usually I'm a member of a lot of groups on Facebook, relationship groups, so I'm going to be using some of the stuff from there. I'm also going to be using personal experience and also friends, family and that sort of thing. So the first dilemma is, I think today's one, I'm just trying to figure out what we're going to talk about today. It's going to talk about, should we move to get in together if we've been dating for more than 5 years? So this particular dilemma is brought up a lot on the groups that I'm a member of, but also this is one that is like a friend that's in this position. So the friend in question, we've been having like lots of conversations about her current situation. She's in a relationship with someone, I think they've been together now probably 8 years. They've got a child together. She also has children from a previous relationship. They've had kind of a near enough stable relationship. They've had their ups and downs like everyone does. But he lives at home with his mum and he is quite in, you know, he's an older guy. I'm not going to say his age, but he's over 45, put it that way. He lives at home with his mum. She lives with the children in another home. And over the past sort of year, I suppose, we've been having conversations. She's not sure as to whether to move in with him or not. Now, some of the things that are blocking whether she should move in with him are because her finances are really good. And apparently he's not good with money, with budgeting. He's got quite a lot of debt. It's not that he's got lots of debt, actually. He does earn good money, but he spends it all. He blows it all. His philosophy on saving and stuff like that is different to hers and budgeting. So that's one of the key things. Another key thing that she's mentioned is because she has lived on her own all of her life, she's kind of used to doing things in a certain way. And what she sort of said was that when he has stayed over or when he does stay over, there's a lot of things which cause an issue, cause friction between them because she does things differently. So what I would say that is if you're in this sort of dilemma, I think with any sort of relationship dilemma, really, what you have to consider is a relationship usually progresses. Let me just get the light a bit because it's a bit dark. Okay, that's a bit better. A relationship for most people has a progression. You know, no one wants to be stuck in a relationship that isn't going anywhere, whether that's moving forward or whether things are just, you know, there's usually a reason that you're in that relationship because, you know, it's not just based on convenience or because you even love the person. You want to move forward together. If that wasn't the case, then you'd be on your own, because if you've got goals, dreams, you've got aspirations, or you see where the relationship is going but the other person is going in a completely different direction, then you are going to get to these dilemmas or this stage where you're stuck or you're at a crossroad. So in this situation, what I would say is that if you've been dating someone or you're in a relationship with someone and it's become serious, and if it goes beyond sort of 5, 10, whatever amount of years, then if you're not living together, then maybe that's something for you to sit down and really think about. Because some of the things that might... Hi, whoever's online, say your name, join in. Whoever, if you're in a relationship and you're saying it's serious because you've got children together, or it's serious because, you know, you love each other, you're committed, you know, there's no one else, you're exclusive, then it's not about society or anyone else saying to you, you should move in together, or you should get married, or you should take the next steps. But you have to think, I suppose, a little bit that if a relationship is about progression, and that's probably like with anyone, anything's about progression, isn't it? It's moving forward, it's about growth, it's about whatever. What is stopping you from taking that next step? Is it because you're not certain about the relationship? So if you're saying it's because this person doesn't budget, if the person has always had financial issues when you met them and you were dating them and you knew that, then moving in, using that as a reason for not moving in together, almost feels like there's more to it. Is it that you're not ready to give up your independence? So with the example I've just used, if my friend has kind of got used to routines and got used to living with herself, getting the kids into a routine, maybe she likes the fact that, you know, her partner comes, stays over, but then he leaves. And I suppose deep down, if we had that chat, you know, together, she would probably say there's a bit of fear there of actually someone moving in permanently. But also for him, if you've got someone who's living at their parents' house, especially at that age as well, he's got a lot to lose as well, because at the moment he's not having to pay as much things out financially. He's got his mum, who's someone who's, you know, probably does everything for him, and is going to sort of be on his side in that way. I think what I would just say to people is you need to really, really sit down and think about what is it that's preventing the next step. Because if you're in a relationship, it's committed, you've got children, you're in love with that person, you're not going anywhere, you're not looking at splitting up, then moving in together probably seems like a reasonable step for two reasons. One, it brings you closer together, not just physically, but also it kind of seals that bond, really. You know, you're not in separate households. And there's nothing wrong with that, because people can choose, if that's what they want to do, have two separate households. It's not a judgment thing. But it's just different. It's like when you're having a long distance relationship, it's different to when you've got someone that's close by. Anything can work. So it's not about whether things can work or can't work. It's about the practicalities and the way that society is at the moment is distance. When you have distance between you, or when people are working long hours, or when people are not connected, they're going to either find other ways to get connections from elsewhere, or there's just going to be stuff that gets lost in the relationship. So what I would say that is just take the chance. You know, what have you got to lose? If you move in with someone and it doesn't work out, you can always just, you know, move separately to different houses. You can still keep the relationship. But I would say that it's probably more about fear. If you don't want to move in with someone, then I think it's more coming from you, a place of fear, and what you feel you're going to have to sacrifice or give up, as opposed to looking at it as being, this could be a really, really good thing for both of us. We could, you know, it could move on then from marriage, or we could see how we operate when we're in, together all the time. So that's sort of the first relationship dilemma. Whoever's online, what are your thoughts on what we've said? And maybe you've got a dilemma of your own, or have you kind of been in this situation where you've had to consider moving in with someone? No? Okay, they just want to watch, and that's fine as well. So as I've said, I'm going to be doing a different dilemma each day. I think I'll stick with kind of my New Journeys counselling page for this week, and then maybe next week I'll go on my personal page. Thank you for watching, and if you want further information, then just go to my Facebook page, which is New Journeys Counselling. You can also make a referral. All the details are on there. Especially if you're a couple, but I also work with individuals with relationship problems as well. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again tomorrow. I don't know what time I'm going to be doing these lives, but I'll let people know in advance. Thanks for watching. Bye.